What is going on, guys? My name is Dimitri and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm gonna break down for you guys a simple weekly agenda that I've made in Notion that can help you guys stay organized on a daily basis and get things that you need to done.
All right, so here's a simple weekly agenda, not as many databases as per usual, and I'm gonna show you guys how to set this up in Notion really quick. Just something simple and easy to get your days nice and organized. And let's get started. So I'm just gonna make a page here, get my little template action going on for you guys. So if we go in to this, let's make it full width. Calendar. Add a cover image of a calendar as well. So weekly agenda. And what we wanna set up here is not what we normally do. I'm gonna put that stuff at the top that you guys saw earlier at the end here. We don't wanna start things off with that guy. We actually just wanna make sure that we get the rest of this sorted. So quick and easy, what we're going to do first is we're actually gonna take some H1s. We can go H1 and just type it Monday and then do a little divider and then do most important tasks, then do some to-dos, and you can do that and then delete these and then put a little divider and then to-dos for the day, do that again, then a little divider. So this is kind of the framework for everything that you're gonna have in this. However, what is your color coding that you wanna have? Do you wanna just keep it white? Do you wanna, like for me, I'm gonna probably put blue for everything. Decide what you guys want before you do all these changes, because after this, I'm gonna show you some pretty nice Notion magic that's gonna make this setup insanely quick. So if we get all this ready to go, what you're then gonna do is you're gonna then decide, okay, for the week, we want Monday through Friday to be in one sort of area. So you're gonna make a 5-column scenario. Got 1 column. Two columns. So it's 3 at the moment. Then we take a third. And then we take a fourth. We should have a 5-column setup here. So what you're gonna wanna do is take these, put it in here, duplicate this guy, and then repeat the process over and over again until we get to where we need to be. So and then right after that, we can go Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and quickly change the color to blue. So then what you can do is on the bottom, I think having the weekend separate is good. We're gonna have some different columns here. So we do not want to have the same number of columns. I would say 3 is enough. So if we quickly take this, make a little divider here, honestly, between the week end and the weekdays, make a triple column where we get 1 here, and then you get 3. So then you can duplicate these 3 times. I actually like to do it 1 at a time so it doesn't get so finicky. Copy this guy. Do it 3 times. Then do the same situation where it's like this one's Sunday. This one's Saturday. And this one for me personally would be any outstanding tasks. And then you can kind of drag this, make the sizing similar to your other days of the week. and that would be your outstanding tasks for the week set up there. Now you don't need to have like this set up here. Personally, I just like keeping it separate, so it's just like this, where it's just the one to do, and then you can decide what you want, but that's my preference. And then if you do another little divider here, what's nice, like for GTD purposes, is if you make one last setup of two different columns, take this guy, put this here, and then take this one more time, drag it here, get this sizing a little bit better, get the setup into a more comfortable spot. So this can be your capture inbox for where any ideas for what you need to do come up. And this can be your someday / maybe section for when you need to get some tasks done. That can just be your like, oh, maybe I need to do this one day. Not really sure, but let me just capture it and then drag it over anyways. So that's like kind of the basic weekly agenda setup. But if we get more into the databases, so for me, as you guys know, I have made a notes database and daily highlight and all that kind of stuff. So really quickly, what you can do is on this top portion, make a slash list, right? So we do a little inline list. This could be your notes database. And really quickly, the properties here are simple. There can be a mood, status, or select. So we go mood, we can go the date, we can go, and I think that's actually one more. We need a relation, but I need to make the second database here. So let me quickly get this triple column set organized. So if we go here, make one more three column setup. It's going to be the notes database tucked in here. After I make a third one properly, my apologies. So now it's set up in three columns. So if we go here, then we can have another sort of board view in line. And then here is where we're going to have an aesthetic widget for the weather. So this will be the daily highlight. So in order to get the emojis edited, we can go in here, add the writing emoji, go back out here. And a really quick and easy filter is to have the date is today. So let's make something today and change this to date. And then make a template where it's daily journal. You can have the daily highlight. Be this. And then we can do the today's journal section where it's like the nightly reflection. And then do something similar. Put whatever icon you want in there. So for me, let's get a notebook in there. I'm always a fan of this one. And what I like to do is I like to go and take a star emoji and copy this in there. So that's like how it would be for one star for the day, two stars, and etc. And then at this point, we can get a sort of mood situation figured out. So then for this view, it's filtered to show where date is today. And then for properties, we can show the mood. So if today's journal, make weekly agenda, mood is a 4. Then for the daily highlight, it's a setup that I've had very much so in some previous videos. It's a great concept. I love it. The board view here is essentially gonna be different. I'm actually gonna edit it inside there just to make it easier on us. The properties here will be as follows. All we're gonna have is the day status, the progress, and then like a checkbox for status. And then we're gonna have a relation to the notes database that's right here. There's so many of these, I just gotta make sure it's the right one. So there we go here, it's this one. And then daily journal. And then this guy's connected here, daily highlight. Then we can get rid of this tags because that was never needed. And then we're just gonna type in for this one, get rid of these. Type the day of the week. So Monday, Tuesday, make all of the days of the week. And then we can have in progress, or we can have current and completed. I always like to have a little green or finished if you want red action. And then the setup here is essentially showing you, we have it grouped by the day. So I'm going to hide this no day to the very end. So then what you can do here is if we go to the properties, get rid of the progress, show the little status. Basically, this is like your daily highlights as you go along. As each day goes along, you just kind of roll with the punches here and you can have make weekly agenda be your Monday one. And then that is how you have the notes database and the daily highlight in this simple and easy view. And then lastly, if we go to indify.co, which is a nice little Notion widget website, we can make a weather widget here. And I'm just gonna take this example really quickly. I like to have the 3 days one. That's a nice few views for me. We can copy a widget like this, go into the weekly agenda, type /embed, then press that link in there, hit enter, size it to be even with this stuff here. And then a last piece de resistance is the divider here. So this is how you can set up a quick and easy weekly agenda in Notion. Now, this is the really easy part you can have here. There's no databases outside of these guys. If you don't want this, don't use it. Might complicate things for you, but I think the daily highlight and journaling daily is a very important thing for your life.
So I hope you guys enjoyed this one, and I will see you in the next one.